I will show you a free software you can use to backtest all your Forex strategies. You can add as many indicators as you want. You can backtest any time frame, even 10 seconds, 5 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 1 hour, 4 hour daily, and you can replay as many candles as you want to any number of years, all for free without paying a dime. And this actually works. I'm going to show you in the next few minutes. So what I want you to do right now, click on the subscribe button to the channel and be a part of the community. And without wasting time, let's go to the screen and I will show you how to backtest right now, completely free.
For you to get this software, what you just need to do is to go to your Chrome browser and search for Dukascopy, then enter it. Now it will take you to this place. Look at this area, Dukascopy Bank SA. Click there, and when you click, it will take you to the Dukascopy website. Go to this area, Forex Trading. Click on the Forex Trading and scroll down. You will see this area, the root Forex through CFD trading platforms. Click on that, and when you scroll down, you will see the JForex, where excellence overwhelms. And this is the software that we'll be using, and it is a very good software for backtesting. So you can use the web version, the mobile, or the desktop. So I want to use the desktop version. So you click on the desktop, come to this area, click there. It will download, and when you download, you install it on your system. I have already installed it on my system, so it is just that easy. If you come to my screen, you will see here JForex. When you install your own, this is how it will appear. So you double click on it to launch the software. What you will see here is that you have the live and the demo. Click on the demo. If you don't have an account, click on this place, create a demo account, fill in your first name, your last name, your email, your nationality, phone number. Then select this one, trading account. Don't select the MetaTrader, binary, and all those ones. We are interested in the trading account. So select that one, and then you will proceed. I have already done that. What you will notice is that they will send you an email with the login detail. Copy the login and the password and paste there, and then you can launch the app. It is that simple, initializing. This is the app that you are going to use for your back testing. If you are new to this platform, what you see here, this token sticker was the one that added, so you can remove that. What you will see, the app will be like this when you newly log in. I want to have a very wide interface for what I want to do. Let's remove all the indicators, because those are indicators I put in. You click on this place to minimize that direction, and also minimize this other side so that you can have a very clean interface for your back testing. If you look at this interface, you see here that you can add all the currency pairs that you want. This place, you can select any time frame. You can see that you have 10 seconds, 1 minute, 5 minutes, down to month. If there is any time frame that you want to use for your back testing, you can click on this add more, and then you can add that time frame. If you come here, you see the candlesticks. You can change your area, line, bar chart, candles. If you move forward, you will also see some of these features. You can take your cursor there. You see your crosshair. This is the measuring instrument, just like what you have on trading view. So if I want to measure anything, I can come here, then move it to any place I want to measure anything. You take it here, then you can measure the number of pips, number of points, and all those things, just like you do on your trading view platform. Then here is to zoom. If you want to zoom out a particular area, you click on that and it will zoom out for you. You can actually scroll back in, you know. Then this one is for indicators. You can add any indicator of your choice. Very soon we will be back testing, so just watch what we will do. So if you come to this indicator window, you see that the indicator is put in different groups. Okay, you can also arrange them in alphabetical order. So if I click alphabetical order, you can find any indicator of your choice. Let's say we want to add MACD. You go to M, where the MACD is. This is MACD, moving average, convergence, and divergence. So I click there. Then you see this add. Sometimes this thing will take the entire screen. If that happens to you, you just minimize it like this. And then you can see moving average, convergence, and divergence. Then you click on add, and you can see it added here. If you want to add simple moving average, you can also follow the same way. Add indicator, arrange alphabetically, go to S, then look for SMA, simple moving average. You can see it. You can add the period, change anything that you want and add, and you see simple moving average there, 30 period. If you want another type of moving average, you can add any type of indicator at all, a lot of them. This area is for drawing tools. So you click that drop down arrow, you will see all the drawing tools. You see your trend line, rectangle, triangle, any tool you like using for your analysis, the volume, risk on, risk off, all the tools that you like using most of the time. You can click on the star to keep them on the favorite. If I click on this place, you see that trend line has been added to my favorite tool. You can select text if you want to be using that most of the time, rectangle, any number of tools that you want to be using most of the time is there. You can select. Then this other area, this is for drawing. Then here you have seen retracement, Fibonacci retracement, Fibonacci expansion, and all those retracement tools. You'll find them there. This for patterns, if you need your ABC pattern, Elliott wave, and all those things. Then this one for icons and all that. The important place that we'll be using for our back testing is this place that look like an hourglass. You see it there, the root replay widget. So click on the replay widget and you have this object here. This is what you will be using for your back testing. This area, see start time, you click there, it will help you to set. You can move your pointer to where you want to start the back testing from. If this place is not enough, you want to go further into history, let me zoom in this thing. You can zoom in and move your this into history. Then you click on this start time. Then once you click on the start time, you can take it to where you want to start. If this place is not enough. Now, for the purpose of those people that have been asking me for training, whether you're a complete beginner who wants to learn how to trade forex, or you have been trading for a while and you want to improve your trading skill, I want to give you an opportunity to join the Weldds Forex Academy today. For the first 10 persons who will send me a message, I am going to allow you to join this academy for just $60. Check the description of this video. You will see a WhatsApp phone number. Send them enough. You still move into history again. Click on the start time and then you take it to wherever you want to start. As you can see here, this is March 2022. You can start your backtesting there. Now, what you need to understand is that there's no limitation to the number of candlesticks that you want for your analysis. So you can zoom out if you want to see clearer. This place, if you want to replay, you click there, it will replay. If you want to replay one candle at a time, you click the second option. This one is a next. You can also jump to the current date, right? When you see here, this place, they say replay mode order. If you want to place your orders, this is the one you will use. But before we go there, let's go to these settings. If you click on settings, it gives you an opportunity to set the amount of money you want to use for your back testing. Let's say I want to start with $10,000. You click. If your trading account that you want to use for your trading is not in US dollar, you can change it to whatever. If it is euro, Canadian dollar, Australian dollar, or pound, you can do that also. You can set the leverage that you want to use. You can also tick whether you want to display the overnight rates and commissions. So once you set and you're okay, you can click okay. Then you click on this replay mode widget. Now this object is out. This is the object you will use to place your sell and your buy. All right, for you to set your orders, maybe you want to set a micro lot 0.01. You use this 1000 represent 0.01. If you want a mini lot 0.1, you use 10,000. A standard lot is 100,000. Okay, you can also set maybe 2 standard lot or 10 standard lot, anyone that you want to use for your entry based on your equity. So let's say right here we want to take a sell from where the market is. You just click on sell and you see that there is a line there showing where your order is. If you take your cursor to that line, you see this SL for stop loss. Move your stop loss to where you want stop loss to be, and then you see the TP. Move the TP to where you want your TP to be. Okay, so that is your take profit and the one up is your stop loss. Then you can begin to play it and you see how it is going. If you want it to go very fast, for you to replay very fast, this is 10 times speed. You can reduce it if it is too fast, then you replay it. All right, just click on the replay and it will keep going. You watch, it is very easy. Now another thing I want to show you, if you want to do pending orders, let's say I want to take a sell stop, I click here and I drag it to where I want to enter. Okay, once I take it there, you see that this is a stop order. So a sell stop, I click my stop loss, drag it up, click my take profit, drag it down. Okay, so just the same way you set your order, that is my set sell stop. If I want to take a sell limit, the same way I can drag it to the upper part of it, and that is a limit order. The same way, if you want to use a buy limit and a buy stop, you use this other side. You can drag and place your orders, and when you have placed your order, you click on the play mode and it will keep on playing for you. Remember, what I am doing here, I am not actually giving you a strategy. I'm only showing you how to use this software. I'm not considering any indicator here to make my decisions. I'm just placing buy and sell at random just to demonstrate what is going on. If you can reduce the speed, just like I increased the speed, just like I told you earlier, on this software you can put any number of indicators that you usually use for your trading and set it up. You can bring out your drawing tools, pause it, bring out your trend line. If you want a trend line, you bring out your trend line and draw the trend line however you want. Okay, if the trend line agrees and you want to give you a buy, you place your order and then you click play mode, and you will backtest to any time that you want, you know, and it is totally free for you to see your result. This place, they say show report. You click there and you can see the report. This is the report. We traded report for GBP US dollar. You see the date that you took the trade. The equity you started with was $10,000. Final equity is $10,080 and all that. Then you can also scroll down and you see the sell orders, the ones that are closed, the ones that are still open. You see it there. So if you like this kind of videos that I keep doing, I want you to click the subscribe button and join the community.